I will first give the floor to Fernando, who will give a brief exposé of what the research he has done and what conclusions he has reached.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon and thank you for coming. This dissertation evaluates the relationships between the structural real exchange rates, the tradable goods share in GDP, and the unemployment rates. At first, the relationships between these variables are assessed from a theoretical point of view, and then they are applied to the Argentinian economy. This presentation will have an introduction in which I will talk about the nominal and real exchange rates, and then I will talk about the theoretical contributions of chapters 2, 3, and 4 of this thesis, which are about the relationships between the real exchange rates, the tradable goods share in GDP, the relative factor prices, the unemployment rates, and the macroeconomic fundamentals of an economy. After that, I will illustrate the relationships between the structural real exchange rates, the tradable goods share in GDP, and the unemployment rates in Argentina. I will also illustrate which were the macroeconomic effects of the closing of the international financial markets on the Argentinian economy of the year 2001. And thereafter, I will analyze the current situation of the Argentinian economy based on the model developed in this thesis. And finally, I will provide you some conclusions. Whenever you go somewhere outside of the Euro countries, you need to change your currency for the currency of the country you are going. And the rate of change is what's called the nominal exchange rate. The nominal exchange rate, however, does not tell us how cheaper or expensive are the foreign goods. You need to know the domestic and foreign prices there. And the concept that relates the domestic and foreign prices and takes into account the role of the nominal exchange rates is the PVP real exchange rate, which is an important concept because it measures the necessary units of domestic goods to buy a unit of foreign goods. When it increases, our competitiveness increases because foreign goods become expensive in terms of our goods, or domestic goods become cheaper in terms of our foreign goods. The PVP real exchange rate, however, does not tell us much about the allocation of resources within an economy, which goods we will end up producing. Tradable goods, which are goods we can sell everywhere in the world, like meat, cereals, or manufacturing goods, or non-tradable goods, which are goods that we can only sell in our countries, like haircuts, housing services, or other services. We need to know the prices of these goods then. And the relative price between the tradable and non-tradable goods, which is known as the structural real exchange rate, will determine the allocation of resources and expenditures. From the producer's point of view, it will tell us how much the economy as a whole has to give up of non-tradable goods for one additional unit of tradable goods, while from the consumer point of view, it will tell us how much the consumer is willing to give up of non-tradable goods for one additional unit of tradable goods. Small economies cannot influence in international markets, and therefore, the domestic price of tradable goods will be equal to the nominal exchange rates times their international prices. That's why the second expression here redefines the structural real exchange rates, which is an important concept, but it is not an isolated one. It can be shown that the PVP real exchange rates depends on the relative structural real exchange rates between countries. Again, small economies cannot influence in the foreign structural real exchange rate, and therefore any desirable change in the PVP real exchange rate, which is a change in our competitiveness, must come through changes in the structural real exchange rates. But notice that it only can happen through external devaluation, which is changes in the nominal exchange rates, or internal devaluation, which is changes in the non-tradable prices. We are interested in the determinants of the structural real exchange rates. And the first determinant is related to the amount of primary goods like cereals and meat and manufacturing goods that we will produce and consume. Then the relative price between primary and manufacturing goods, which is known as the terms of trade, will also influence the allocation of resources and expenditures, and therefore the structural and PVP real exchange rates. But how things are made? We need resources like labor and capital in order to produce tradable and non-tradable goods. How much of labor and capital each sector will use will depend on the relative factor prices and the resources available of an economy. And what about the size of the tradable sector? In this case, In this thesis, the size of the trade-off sector is measured by the trade-off goods share in GDP, and it will be determined when producers, taking into account the sector productivities, the factor endowments, the relative factor prices, the structural real exchange rates, and the terms of trade. So now we can have the idea that the structural real exchange rates, the tradable goods shares in GDP, and the relative factor prices are endogenous variables which are interrelated, and they are determined by fundamentals like sector productivities, factor endowments, and the terms of trade. Which are the fundamentals that determine these variables? Government spending. Because government spending changes the demand for all goods, and therefore the structural real exchange rates, and through it, the tradable goods shares in GDP, and the relative factor prices. When an economy receives external transfers, or has to pay the interest of their debt, like in the Greece case, then they will have to change the consumption patterns, and it will change the demand for all goods, and therefore the structural real exchange rates, the tradable goods shares in GDP, and the relative factor prices. Here I'm illustrating the relationships between these variables, but the thesis shows how these variables are determined in terms of macroeconomic fundamentals like sector productivities, factor endowments, terms of trade, government spending, and external debt services and transfers. Up to now, real exchange rate models reach a single equation for the structural real exchange rates in terms of macroeconomic fundamentals, while development models are interested in the evolution of the size of the tradable sector in terms of macroeconomic fundamentals. Recently, Roderick and Van der Ploeg have suggested that the structural real exchange rates and the size of the tradable sector are indeed interrelated. They, however, evaluate the role only of sector productivities and external transfers. Furthermore, this thesis shows that when the relative factor prices are constant, when there is economic crisis, a firm wants to make some adjustments, and they ask you to have less money, and if you don't want, they will fire you, so there will be unemployment. And in this case, this model shows that when the relative factor prices are constant, the structural real exchange rates, the tradable goods shares in GDP, and the unemployment rates will be interrelated, and they will be determined by fundamentals like sector productivities, factor endowments, terms of trade, government spending, and external debt services and transfers. The formal relationships are explained in the thesis, but here I'm only illustrating those relations only. And for the Argentinian case, I will illustrate the relationships between the structural real exchange rates, the tradable goods share in GDP, and the unemployment rates. The T-shaped P line here shows the producer's decision, and it has a positive slope because the tradable goods share in GDP increases when the structural real exchange rate increases. The T-shaped C line here shows the consumer's decision, and it exhibits a negative slope because larger tradable goods share in GDP create an excess supply of tradable goods and an excess demand for non-tradable goods, and therefore the structural real exchange rate must appreciate in order to switch expenditures from non-tradable to tradable goods and to restore the equilibrium of the current account and the non-tradable markets. When consumers and producers' decisions coincide, then de facto the goods markets will be in equilibrium. When the employed labor force, however, increases, the retribution of all factors increases, but the income of the tradable sector does not change at the initial structural real exchange rate, and therefore the tradable goods shares in GDP will diminish to 0.8. Note, however, that the production of all sectors has increased, there will be an excess supply of non-tradable goods that will push non-tradable prices down, and therefore the structural real exchange rates up to point B. That's why here the SRIER line shows all the combinations between the structural real exchange rates and the employed labor force that are compatible with the equilibrium of the goods markets. An economy have a fixed labor force, and therefore the unemployment with the employed labor force will be negative related. But what about the factor markets? It can be shown that in Argentina, when the Argentinian structural real exchange rate increases, then the employed labor force increases because the tradable sectors require more labor than the non-tradable sector releases. The L line here shows all the combinations between the structural real exchange rates and the employed labor force that are compatible with the equilibrium of the factor markets. What about the equilibrium values of the structural real exchange rate, tradable goods shares in GDP, and unemployment rates? They are determined when the goods and factor markets are simultaneously in equilibrium. And it happens here at point E0GM and E0GE. Economic fundamentals will displace any of these lines, and they will change the equilibrium values of these variables. But notice that economic fundamentals, when they change any of these lines, we will have change in the equilibrium points, but we are interested in this, in the interdependent relationships. We can just not get the economy will be at this point without not knowing how these relationships. And in the thesis details how economic fundamentals affect these variables. But what happens when the international financial markets are closed? Then consumers have to adjust their consumption patterns. And in this case, the T-shirt C1 line here shows the consumers' decisions in line with the equilibrium of the current account and the non-tradable markets under the new conditions of the international financial markets. In normal conditions, the equilibrium should be reached at point E1GM and E1GE. And there will be an increase in the size of the tradable sector. There will be a depreciation of the structural real exchange rate, and the unemployment rate will diminish. But what happens? What happened in Argentina in 2001? The nominal exchange rate was constant. So any depreciation of the structural real exchange rate must come through internal devaluation, changes in the non-tradable prices. But the non-tradable prices barely diminished. So the economy was actually in disequilibrium. Producers were here, consumers were here, there was a disequilibrium in the current account. And the reduction of the consumption was pushing unemployment up. At the end, Argentina devaluated because Argentina could devaluate. But what's happening with Greece now? Greece cannot devaluate. And reductions of the non-tradable prices of 20 or 30% are difficult, but they must apply these adjustment measures. So what can the European Union do to help Greece? They can implement direct policies that increase the productivity in the tradable sectors, for example. They will they will move this line to this point, and the economy will be in equilibrium. There will be adjustments, but the adjustment will not be painful like they are without help. But about the current situation of Argentina, nowadays there is inflation in Argentina, and the inflation rate is higher than the devaluation. It can be shown then that the PVP and the structural real exchange rate are diminishing. But inflation does not change the macroeconomic fundamentals of an economy. So the economy should be at the initial equilibrium point, E0GM and E0GE, but the structural real exchange rate is appreciated. So producers are diminishing the production of tradable sectors. They are releasing labor, and that labor is not employed by the non-tradable sector. So unemployment is expected to increase. On the other side, consumers are consuming more tradable goods than they should be, and therefore the current account is in disequilibrium, and there are shortages of foreign currencies. What should I suggest? A straight devaluation for Argentina? Theoretically, yes, but I wouldn't do it because there is inflation going on in Argentina. They first have to apply a stabilization program, and then they can devaluate. Otherwise, people will think that the devaluation is just catching up with the inflation, and that the inflation will be again higher than the devaluation, and the economy will be again in disequilibrium. What can Argentina do if they want to keep their currency appreciated? They can increase the productivity in the tradable sectors, and they can reduce also the government spending that falls in non-tradable goods. In that case, there will be a real depreciation of the structural real appreciation of the structural real exchange rate, and the economy will be in equilibrium. And now I would like to talk about the main takeaways of this presentation, and they are about the interdependencies between the structural real exchange rates, the tradable goods share in GDP, and the relative factor prices, or the unemployment rate when the relative factor prices are constant. This thesis proposes that these variables are simultaneously determined, and they are interrelated. For Argentina, we found that the structural real exchange rate and unemployment rate are negatively related, and the relationships between structural real exchange rates and the tradable goods sharing GDP are in line with the consumers' and producers' decisions. Economic policies should be evaluated thinking in the interdependent relationships and equilibrium relationships, because if we don't know the interdependent relationships, we cannot know in which point the economy is. And the effects of paying debt services or having appreciated real exchange rates can be offset by productivity improvements and reductions in the government spending that falls in non-tradable goods. That's all from me. Thank you.
This is a Blas work that says, well, on this day, the 19th of June 2012, the Faculty of Applied Economics has conferred the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, PhD in Applied Economics, and it's something that you can take with you wherever you go. We hear that you come from far, that you are still going very far when you become governor of central bank, or you can put it on your desk. It fits very easily in a suitcase, so it's something very nice to remember this fantastic day.